Welcome. My name is Dan Wasink, and I create video tutorials on how to use the Mac, iPad, iPhone, Apple Watch, and Apple TV. In this video, we're going to take a look at the new multi-stop routing feature we have available to us in the Maps app on the iPad. We can now add multiple stops when we're creating a route, and we can plan that route around traffic. Let's see how we do this. Let's go over to my iPad. First thing we need to do is open up the Maps app, of course. So I'm going to go over to my Maps app here. And I'm going to create a route. For Thanksgiving, what we're going to do is go over to Kansas City. So I just type in here, search maps. I'm going to type in here, Kansas City. I need directions. And you're going to see what I'm able to do is add a stop. The way that we're going to go through or go to Kansas City is via Des Moines. We're going to go and visit my aunt over in Des Moines. So what I need to do is I need to add a stop in here. So now what I do is I tap on add stop and I type in Des Moines. And what I need to do is rearrange this. We're not going to Kansas City first. We are going to Des Moines first. So now what I do is I just drag this up and we have my new route. We can see it routed us through Des Moines here. If I want to add more stops, I can tap on add stop. If I want to remove a stop, maybe we're not going to Kansas City anymore, or maybe we're not going to Des Moines anymore. All I have to do is just swipe over to the left and I can delete a stop. Now, in addition to that, what I can also do is plan this around traffic. How do we do that? Well, you're going to see to the right of drive. If I tap on this, it's going to drive me there or give me the route that's there. But also, if we go over to the right, you're going to see it says now. If I were to leave right now, what it would do is it would take me 9 hours and 33 minutes with one stop. Well, I wonder if I left later, would I be able to cut that time out? Maybe if I left 8 o'clock in the morning, would it be shorter or would it be longer? Let's find out. The way that we do that is we go over to now, and I type in the date that we're leaving as well as the time. So let's just go with tomorrow, and I'm just going to go with 8 a.m. I tap on done. We can see leave Friday at 8 a.m. It is still 9 hours and 35 minutes. Let's go and put the weekend in there. We can only plan this out for 2 weeks. So I'm going to go with leave Friday. I know we're leaving on Thanksgiving, but if we look, you're going to see I can't plan that far out. I can only go a couple of weeks out. So what we're going to do is go with Saturday at 10 a.m. Let's sleep in a little bit. I tap on done. It's calculating how much time that's going to take. And we can see it'll take about 2 minutes shorter. So not a lot of traffic apparently from where I live over to Kansas City. Now, how does it compute this time? Well, it's based on predicted traffic. So it's going to look at trends and it's going to predict what the traffic is going to be. So it's not going to be 100% accurate, of course, but it will give you an idea of when the best time to leave for your location is, for your destination. So that's the new multi-stop routing we have in the Maps app. We can now add multiple routes. We can rearrange those. We can remove those routes. And then we can get an estimated time of how long it's going to take based on traffic conditions. All we have to do is just enter in a date up to 2 weeks ahead and then a time. And then we're going to see a calculated time based on predicted traffic of how long that route is going to take. So that is the new multi-stop routing we have with the Maps app on the iPad with iPadOS 16.